Good morning to the respected panelists and student managers. Today we are here for the induction presentation. I'm Aarti Ghatge.
And I'm Vandana Rudola, and we are from River Yamuna. So, here's a question for all of you guys. Who do you think is the biggest retailer in the world? Okay, you guys are right. So, video.
Than ever to make Christmas shopping easier. Save money, live better. Walmart.
So our today's topic of presentation is study on consumer satisfaction at best price by Walmart. And the contents of our today's presentation are Walmart at a glance, Walmart transforming to serve customers better, Walmart products, Walmart India revenue, Walmart India market share, comparison, customer satisfaction, strategic goals, and at last, conclusions.
So the vision of Walmart, it is to be the best retailer in the hearts and minds of the employees and the customers. Mission is saving the money of their customers so they live better. And our objective is to analyze the performance and actions to meet the needs and requirements of the customer.
Starting from the introduction, Walmart is an American multinational retail corporation that operates a chain of hypermarket, retail, department stores and grocery stores. It was founded by Sam Walton in 1962 in Arkansas, USA, and in 1970 they expanded their business and gained popularity. In 1990 they became the national retailer, and in 2003 they became the world's best corporation. Now Walmart is transforming to serve customers better. The most important reason for the customer to feel satisfied and happy through Walmart is they feel like they have the lowest price than any other, comparatively any other retail stores. Second, the Walmart slogan, that is saving people's money so they can live better lives, are categorized into three groups. First, brand inspirational, which includes those people who have low incomes, but they just obsess with big brand names. And the second one, price sensitive affluence, are those suppliers, moderate suppliers who love to deal. And the value price shoppers are those who just love low price for the best quality of products. Second, products. Some of the products of Walmart includes electronics, food, accessories. In electronics, we have so many products like laptop, computers, TV, and many more. And in food, we have beverages, organic food, frozen food, condiments, sauces, and spices. And in accessories, we have men's and women's clothing, shoes, jewelries, and watches. And there are so many other more products. Now, Walmart India revenue. This is a data fiscal year from 13-14 to 16-17 consecutive years, and this shows a rapid increase, successive increase in a revenue, annual growth revenue. The Walmart purchased Flipkart in a year 2018. It's because Walmart wants to enter into the Indian e-commerce sector but couldn't be able to make so because through direct FDI, that is foreign direct investment. So they just bought Flipkart, and now it has a stake of Flipkart stake of 77% in share, and they can take any major decisions in Flipkart.
Coming to the market share of Walmart majorly is concentrated on Flipkart. Almost 31.9% of market share is dominated by Flipkart, and Amazon takes 31.1%. Walmart group of companies, that is Jabong, Myntra, Flipkart, altogether makes 39.5%, which gives a tough competition to Amazon. So we can see that the major competitor of Walmart is Amazon. Though Walmart and Amazon are rapidly increasing their business and growing in their business, in the last from the last few years, but the revenue of Walmart exceeds that of Amazon. Customer satisfaction. We can see from the fiscal year 2015 to 2018, there has been increase in the customer satisfaction. That is due to trained employees. They train the employees so as to greet and treat the customers well. Bonuses and increased wages for employees. Walmart has invested around $2.3 billion to increase the minimum wages of their employees. Better cleanliness and increased standard of the stores, better deals than the competitors. They use the concept of EDLP, that is everyday low price, to give better discounts and offers. Strategic goals, dominate the retail market. Okay, any company for that matter, dominating the retail market obviously has a huge customer base. And huge customer base makes more profit. Growth by expansion. There are many ways to strengthen a company's growth. Walmart all over the world has around 11,718 outlets. They can increase the number of outlets to gain maximum consumer base. Widespread name recognition and customer satisfaction, that can happen through advertisements and discounts offered, but word of mouth is also important in the marketing, and that happens only when the customer is well satisfied. Branching out into new sectors of retailing, Walmart was only into the retail store, and then it got into the e-commerce sector. That shows that the adaptability of Walmart.
Okay. So here's a question for you guys. How many of you agrees with the fact that Walmart Flipkart deed is a bad omen for the startups that wants to grow independently? How many of you guys agree with this? Like, no one? How many of you guys think that Walmart Flipkart deal is a bad omen for the startups who aims to grow independently? Okay.
Coming to the conclusion, as discussed before, Walmart India entered the retail, Indian retail and e-commerce through Flipkart, and the annual growth is rapidly increasing with the revenue of 19,900 crore INR. Walmart believes the happier employees help to achieve customer satisfaction. Also, they maintain the standard of the outlets, and standard of the outlets has been increased to satisfied customers along with the best deal.
Thank you.
Thank you.